hooked on a feeling. I'm high on believing that you're in love with me. Lips as sweet as candy, its taste is on my mind. Girl, you got me thirsty for another.
Finally, a calm day on the Aegean side of Greece. We've waited a long time for this. It's lovely. Even the jellyfish are enjoying it.
When we're all alone, keep it up, girl. Yeah, you turn me on. Ah, hooked on a feeling.
There you go.
Very good.
What do you think about today's trip, Al?
Cool.
Cool?
Yeah, comfortable.
Yeah. A bit different to the other day.
The other day was really good as well.
Check out what Jen's doing. Oh, she's reading her fifth book.
And enjoying it.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's beautiful, isn't it? Great reading day today.
Sun tanning day as well.
Yeah, so we've had a bit of sun out the front, haven't we?
We have, but I think I've had enough.
Yeah, measured doses.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
I'm hooked on a feeling.
I'm now a sailor. I've got ropes in my hands.
You've got no sails up though.
Well, working on it.
I think you've peaked a bit early. I'll come back to you when you've got a sail up.
I'll show you how to do one side and you can do the other whilst I prepare to sail. Yep, we go through this one here, on the back, and we run it under everything. Back behind this?
Yep.
Through there, through that block.
Yep, and just tie it on a clove hitch here. Beautiful. Okay, one down. The green ones are the buffalo girls, they go round the outside, round the outside.
Through the top here.
Okay, now out through there, yep. And on the outside of the stay.
Same on the other side, mate. And I'll get the sail ready and you can run the other two lines.
Sails here, ready to tie those sheets and dies on. Front block. So what are you doing there, Mick?
Just attaching the guys and the sheets to the parasailer.
Yep.
Well, I just like to make sure that we've got the bottom of the parasailer so we know that, well, we hope that's not twisted in the bag.
Which happened last time, didn't it? So we could have a bit of a mess here today. But you normally just run your hands along the bottom of the sail to make sure that you've got the port and starboard sides of the sail set correctly.
Sheet always goes on top of the guy. Like that. Sheet on top of the guy.
Beautiful.
So the guy's on the foot. I think it's the foot. Someone will correct me on that if it's not. We're good to go.
Fantastic.
I'll just double check. When we're good to go, we're going to wrap it three times, round through there, and that button there is up. Good. Yeah. have to come right off the juice, I think.
Darling, stop.
Eyes are the same length now, the two red lines. Yep.
Yep, that looks pretty good. Of happiness. Things have been done for too long.
Don't change me up. Don't change me.
Us Aussies to go through the Corinth Canal. This is the canal that separates the sort of mainland Greece from the Peloponnesus section of Greece. It's a bit of a shortcut. Instead of going back down around the southern tip like Michael and I did when we came up here, so it's apparently going to cost us a couple hundred euros to go through here, but yeah, we're really excited. Something different. It's in that gap there with that bridge above it. The canal's 3.2 miles long, it's 25 meters wide, and the walls of the canal are, you know, between 56 and 78 meters high, so it should be quite spectacular.
We'll go and check them out at the office, and if we can head through now we will. If not, we'll go over here and drop anchor.
That's us, we're going through there. Definitely not your average sea journey, this one. Oh, it's awesome. It's cool, isn't it?
Stunning.
Yeah.
We might jag this.
Oh, there's a tanker coming through.
Well, that big ship.
Or it might be the one going through.
No, I reckon he's going.
He's filled the hole up, anyway.
So I reckon it's shut at the moment.
Where's the hydraulic bridge, guys?
Right in front of us, though.
Oh, there's a car going across it.
Yeah. We're going to tie up. Suss it out, eh? Righto. I'm going to face into the wind, so we'll go front rope first.
Okay.
I don't think there's going to be anyone here, so you're going to have to lasso it. We might go that little one for you, Doug.
Yeah. Sometimes you bend, sometimes you stand. I'm the world's worst rope thrower, and I've got to lasso this thing. Not my forte. I haven't lassoed a bollard for 5 months, so this will be interesting.
Well,
Rita's psyching herself up.
Let's see if she can do it.
Yes!
Aww!
Yep. That went exactly how I thought it would.
I need to let that off.
So we're tied up here alongside the wharf, just at the beginning of the canal. The gate's shut at the moment, so we can't go through. So Mick's gone to see the man and do the paperwork, and hopefully we can go through this afternoon. I had a little visit from the guard dogs that are looking after the fuel truck. I don't think they're very ferocious though. They came up barking but wagging their tails, and now they're sitting there like this. Do you want to explain?
Been a long day. What have to do, you read this sign and you've got to go up there and talk to the dude.
Yep, yep. Right.
Get that to happen.
Yep.
And then off we go.
Off you go.
That's it.
Easy.
Simple.
Right. Because I love their stamps in Greece. What's the deal?
178 euros, 30 minutes. We can stay for one hour, spin around and transit.
Cool.
And did you claim Mick Island?
I actually asked him where do I claim. We've just found a new island. We want to call it Mick and Allen Office.
Yeah.
And he said, oh, different office, mate.
Oh. Always a different
option. So we're going to have to go somewhere else to claim our island.
He's got you guys on a technicality, I think. They haven't got a stamp for that.
It was actually good because these guys here are going through. The paperwork is better than checking into a country.
Yeah. Didn't have to lean forward and cough.
No, he was really good. In fact, I only halfway got through the paperwork and he said, just sign here. I had to put our last port and our next port. I said, I don't know what our next port is. I think we'll stop on the other side of the canal. And he just said, just put Corinth off. So that's what we do. We're going to Corinth.
What's happening, guys?
People come through the other way. So
our turn next.
I reckon we're close.
There's a bit of a convoy of yachts coming through. Just made a start on dinner while we were waiting to go through the Corinth Canal, but we've been called, so I've got to turn it off.
West stands receiving.
You may proceed, you may go through now.
Thank you, West stands proceeding. Have a...
Catamaran.
That's correct, let's dance catamaran.
Like the catamaran, okay. After the tugboat and the small motor yacht, you may go.
Just this way.
Okay, we'll follow the tugboat and the sailing yacht through. Let's dance standby on channel 11.
You don't follow the tugboat. After the tugboat, the exit of the tugboat. Behind you is the tugboat. Going out.
You're going first.
Your vessel and enter now.
Great. Sorry, you want me to go first, Ada?
Are you on the fenders, guys?
Here we go.
How cool.
Once upon a time, when this canal wasn't here, apparently they dragged boats overland to get from the Ionian to the Aegean. 3.2 kilometres to drag a boat.
These people are all waiting for the boats to go past so that they can drive across again. This is gorgeous. Yes, sir? What's the depth in here, Skipper?
7.1 meters.
Okay.
these guys up here off this bridge are bungee jumping.
Oh, they are.
What an amazing place to bungee jump.
Amazing.
It's better than I expected. I just didn't think it would be this spectacular. That's us there, trekking across that piece of land. You pair?
So that's it, Corinth Canal behind us. We're going to hang up, turn to the port side. We've got Corinth on our left hand side. Go over there, drop our anchor, and celebrate our transit. That's it.
Okay, that's where we're going. Pretty sad looking place, but it'll suffice for the night. Pleased to meet you.
You look like familiar, that's why I'm looking at you like a first time in Greece.
I know, we came to Agostoli and then down and to the south.
We come through
and
the
other
canal.
Year and other year, because we are good people and good weather.
That's the way I like it. That's the way I like it.
Way down the back, enjoying the ride. can't see as well here, but that's okay. Our boat's just anchored off it here in a nice calm little bay, and yeah, it's really good. Great way to see Delphi. Explain what happened when you got on the bus and the disturbance.
We had our ticket and then this old woman said she wanted our seat.
Actually, I'm not sure
whether it was. So all us guys,
yeah, and these guys here, they were in on the disturbance. Yeah, it just was carnage. Anyway, we're happy at the back, aren't we?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah,
it's much better.
That's where the problem was.
See our boat?
Your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war, you could talk to God, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
If we knew Braille, we could actually find out what this is. There's no other sign, just Braille.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck, dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
So once we found a sign that wasn't Braille, we've been able to read a little bit more about Delphi. Some of these buildings were built between 4 and 7 AD, but there are also remains of civilizations from 465 BC. A lot of the monuments here are dedicated to gods like Apollo and Delphi, hence the name. Yeah, it's very spectacular. This gorge that is behind the town is just dramatic. It's beautiful.
Up there, water drying system.
Yeah, it's awesome, isn't it?
You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. All the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
We've just about walked a kilometre up to somewhere near the top of Delphi. And there's a stadium here. You get your beer credits coming up here.
That's a long walk to the footy, that's for sure. It's quite steep, but we're here. Let's go and have a look.
The stadium is incredible. Sitting on a plateau at the foot of these huge cliffs, just stunning. So this stadium was originally built in the 2nd century BC. And it was a racetrack, and then they added seats into the 5th century AD. We kind of ended up having like an Olympic Games here.
5th century BC racing track.
Oh.
By the Pythian.
Right.
But then it was added to by the Romans. So originally they used to sit on the ground, then the Romans took over, and they built in the stone seats that you can see.
It's 179 metres long.
Which is equivalent to one Pythian.
Is it?
Well, that's what it says there.
All right. Good. Did you say you feel like going for a run?
Yeah. There's a sign over there that says, ascent is not allowed. But how cool would it be?
Would you take your clothes off like the Greeks did?
It'd be a cool nudie run.
Olympic Stadium?
Nah, close. No cigar.
Athenian Stadium.
Pythian Stadium.
Pythian? Oh, right, the famous Pythian
Stadium. Yeah, that one.
I knew what you were talking about.
This is second. These games were second only to the Olympic Games. Check it out.
Oh.
I'll wait until you get up here. It's super impressive.
The thing would be just getting here.
Well, I said and read it on the way up. You'd want to pick your best bloody
athlete,
top 11 to play the game for the weekend because they would, by the time they got up here, they'd be stuffed.
What do they do for oranges and
quarter time.
Well, imagine the ball boys.
Yeah. You'd have to run north, south, you'd want to run east, west.
Isn't that impressive?
Is that where they let the lines out?
No, they didn't have lines.
No, it's discus and javelin and running. With only a helmet on, because you need your helmet.
The Pythian winners were rewarded with a palm tree. Big bloody whoop. What about a slab?
Can either of you see any palm trees here, though?
Mm-hmm. That's why they stopped.
It's special.
The prizes run out. Yeah, they run out.
They ran out of prizes.
Out of prize money.
Yeah, so you just come up one day and go,
this is the spot.
Free sailing. Oh, and by the way, can you put a couple of stands in as well?
And he's gone like this. He's gone like this.
Yeah.
Yeah. One Pythian, 178.35 metres.
Yeah.
I think this is the spot.
Righto, I'll come back after lunch. And then walks off.
What are you doing?
It's a non-stroke technique. The name of the technique is Ramos Project.
Right.
We are going to identify the pigments.
Okay. Thank you. So they're identifying the pigments that have been used in these sculptures to colour them.
Politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.